And here we go. Are we doing the fake? They tried to do the fake, but the ref went up and got the ball. That was a good kick. That was a good ball. So you can see, Nadia, if you're playing in that position, Abby dropped that ball to the backside, and our team clustered in to get it. A head on that ball would have put it in the goal. Challenge Henley. You see Henley go in for that. She went in strong and no hesitation, and she got that ball. So as you challenge for that and you're going to come in close to another player, you got to go in with no hesitation and let yourself bounce off of him. Anytime Sid gets the ball, give her some direction.
Nice work, Blue. Nice work.
Sid punched it up the middle, and they got a shot off, but there were people open both on both sides, both wings. And if you talk to her, time, wing. She's going to have a much better sense of what to do with that. Got lucky, but you were doing it right. Good vocals. Good domination play by the keeper. So as that ball came down towards Sid, you could see Sid was playing a strong position on that ball, and if it had bounced funny, it could have gone over her. You would have had to have been prepared for a backwards play by her. That's always a danger with those high bounce balls. So always plan for those bounces to get over the defense or have the defense not get the right bounce that they expect and have to play a challenge. So the last two corners haven't gotten the height that the first one did. And they're running into traffic instead of getting over into danger. Just like that. So you could see the bounce came off the ground funny and it went over her head. That's where you and your team have to be ready for that screwy bounce to come over their heads. It's also why as a keeper, we talk about keep the ball in front of you. When it's a high ball, you got to drop so that you can keep it in front of you. Ball. So as Abby dumps those balls out to the wing, and the wing's dumping them right back in, the wing can take a little bit more space and try to draw the defense open a little bit more. Call the challenge. People are just running with her. Call the step. Sid's holding way back. There we go. Hear the push up. Good focus, keep talking. Job. Thank you.
to kick on the floor.
So he just told you to call a higher line because he wants you to be able to catch the bounce and to get up to that ball because he doesn't think it's going to be as long a kick. So you as a keeper have to figure out where you think that ball is going to go. Good reaction. Good job. Always start on a free kick with the premise that you need to be on your line so that you can get a high ball before it gets under the bar. However, at that distance, the likelihood was that she wasn't going to be able to get. Good job. The likelihood was that she wasn't going to be able to get it that far in the air, so it was going to bounce before it got to you, and that's why coach was telling you to play a higher line, because if it's going to bounce before it gets to you, you want to be able to get to it as early as possible. If at all possible, you want to keep it from bouncing, simply because it takes a variable out of the equation. If you don't have to worry about whether it's going to hit the ground and go sideways because the bounce is weird, it takes a Chatham County bounce, then you have a better shot at saving it. All right, now drop to your line. Line! So the reason we say line here, the reason we say line here is because it's possible she can get it to you. Good feet movement, good prep, good focus. That was good setup. Didn't have to use it because she kicked it wide. Step. You can call the step too. Draws. Look how much space that opened up, pulling that step up. When you're under pressure, that space is very important, because that space allows you to play sweeper instead of keeper. You can still play keeper if they get a long ball off to you, and it rolls into the box. But it's much safer to play that roll than hard direct shots.
Yeah.
job. Get it out of space. That was good. That pass out got it out of traffic. Traffic followed it, and that's fine. But always understand that the goal is to keep the ball away from traffic, not try to put it through traffic if you're playing the field. So you could have called Sid to keep that ball heading backwards. She had time to turn it. And instead of dropping it into traffic, you could have moved it and switched sides by passing it back through you. Good. Good call. Gray had game brain, so she needed a couple more times to get it through, but she didn't have time, so she just took it. But that was good play and good vocals on you. Good call. Step. Thank you. So, for your field learning, what coach was trying to set up was Scarlett as an outside play, because it was an indirect kick. They can't score directly. Somebody has to touch it before it goes in. So what he wanted Gray to do was kick it out to Scarlett, who was behind all the defenders and could just drop it in from out there. So as you look at that play, what he was looking for was to get somebody out there and pass around, essentially, only from a free kick scenario. So as you see those when you're out there, understand what the goal is when you're playing field, is to get out and around that wall. And that's where Scarlett was positioned. Good half.